Welcome to microbiology classroom. Today I want to discuss about Berke's manual of systematic bacteriology, second edition. Classification schemes of prokaryotes and Berke's manual of systematic bacteriology. Berke's manual for classification of prokaryotes. Classification of prokaryotes began early in the 20th century when great amount of information on various organisms had been accumulated. Carl Lehmann and R.O. Newman in 1903 established the beginning of a manual for classification of prokaryotes. Carl Lehmann and R.O. Newman, 1903, they first published a manual for classification of bacteria. That is the first time bacterial staining reactions and the ability of the organisms to produce endospores, spore formation, were considered as the identification feature, diagnostic feature for identification of the bacteria and for classification of the bacteria. First time Lehmann and Newman, these two scientists, Carl Lehmann and R.O. Newman, 1903, first published a manual for classification of bacteria using bacterial staining reactions and the endospores, ability of the bacteria to produce endospores. So by using these staining reactions, first they published a manual for identification and classification of bacteria. Later, number of bacteria are identified, a number of significant characteristics of the bacteria including the biochemical activities, metabolic activities, serology and pathogenicity and various other characteristics are studied by different scientists. Those characteristics are also incorporated in identification and classification of bacteria. Between 1916 and 1918, Robert Early Buchanan wrote a number of papers on the nomenclature and classification of bacteria, which provided the ground for further activity. It was this time that David Hendricks Berge, professor of bacteriology at the University of Pennsylvania, decided to put his own studies of bacteria together with the view of other eminent bacteriologists on classification of bacteria. This led to the publication of first edition of Berke's Manual of Determinative Bacteriology in 1923 by Society of American Bacteriologists under the chairmanship of David Hendricks Berge and four others, F.C. Harrison, R.S. Breed, B.W. Hammer and F.M. Huntoon. David Hendricks Berge, born on December 27, 1860, in Shippack Township, Montgomery, in Pennsylvania State. Montgomery County in Pennsylvania State. He studied his formal education. Then he took medical training under a local physician, Dr. Samuel Wolf of Shippack Township. He took medical training in old-fashioned way in the office of local physician, Dr. Samuel Wolf of Shippack. Later, he entered at University of Pennsylvania for scientific and medical training and secured BS degree and MD degrees simultaneously in 1884. Dr. Henry Farmad of medical school during that time making his visits to Koch laboratory during that period, Robert Koch laboratory during that period. Dr. Henry Farmad two times visited to Robert Koch laboratory during that period. Dr. Berge received first introduction of bacteria by Dr. Henry Farmad in Dr. Farmad's laboratory, and from his lectures, and he understood the germ theory of disease. So Dr. Henry Farmad introduced bacteria and germ theory of disease to Dr. Berge. After completion of MD degree in 1884, David Berge practiced medicine in North Wales, Pennsylvania from 1884 to 1893. In 1893, he returned to university, Pennsylvania University. There, he again entered as a student, and later he became SCAT fellow in hygiene laboratory, and in hygiene laboratory, newly built hygiene laboratory, he became SCAT fellow in 1893. In 1895, he became assistant in chemistry. In 1896, he became first assistant in chemistry when Dr. Abbott was appointed as director of hygiene laboratory in 1896. In 1903, David Berge became as assistant professor of hygiene and bacteriology in the Pennsylvania University. In 1926, he became as a professor of hygiene and bacteriology to the medical students at Pennsylvania University. In that capacity, he retired in 1932. In 1901, he published a book, Principles of Hygiene, in 1901 during his professorship. In 1901, he published the Principles of Hygiene, and he became the director of the hygiene laboratory in 1929 and served in university posts until his retirement in 1932. He was the director of biological research of National Drug Company in Philadelphia until his death in 1937. David Berge was known for publishing the first classification of prokaryotes. In 1923, he published Berge's Manual of Determinative Bacteriology, first edition of Berge's Manual of Determinative Bacteriology, that appeared in 1923. David Hendricks Berge published Handbook of Practical Hygiene in 1899, and he also published The Principles of Hygiene in 1901. His research included various topics such as tuberculosis, food preservatives, phagocytosis by WBC, anaphylaxis, anaphylactic reaction, hypersensitive reaction, and a systematic arrangement of microorganisms under schizomycetes. David Hendricks Berge, professor of bacteriology at the University of Pennsylvania, decided to put his own studies of bacteria together with other eminent bacteriologists and their views on classification of bacteria. This led to the preparation of the first edition of Berge's Manual of Determinative Bacteriology in 1923 by the Society of American Bacteriologists. American Society of Microbiology, now it is called as, earlier it was called as American Society of American Bacteriologists, now it was renamed as American Society for Microbiology. Under the editorship of David H. Berge and four others, F.C. Harrison, R.S. Breed, B.W. Hammer and F.M. Antoon, the first edition of Berge's Manual of Determinative Bacteriology was published in 1923. Under the chairmanship of editorial board, under the chairmanship of David Berge, and there are four other editors, and the first edition of Berge's Manual of Determinative Bacteriology was published in 1923. The Berge's Manual of Determinative Bacteriology has subsequently been published in further 8 editions. Second edition published in 1925, third edition published in 1930, later fourth and fifth, sixth, seventh and eighth editions are also published. Berge's Manual of Determinative Bacteriology has subsequently published up to 8 editions. The Journal of Bacteriology was established by the Society of American Bacteriologists during the time Dr. Berge was the president of the society. Over the years, information about the new bacteria was incorporated, significant advances that has made, and new organisms identified, all these things are incorporated into the new editions. Since 1923, it has gone through number of editions. Since 1923, it has gone through a number of editions. 8 editions are published as Berge's Manual of Determinative Bacteriology. The 9th edition was published as Berge's Manual of Systematic Bacteriology in 1980. So this was known as first edition of Berge's Manual of Systematic Bacteriology. It has came in 1980. So where new type of classification that was there in the Berge's Manual of Systematic Bacteriology. So this was published in 1984 in 4 volumes. Berge's Manual of Systematic Bacteriology, first edition, was published in 1984. The earlier 8 editions are known as Berge's Manual of Determinative Bacteriology. Berge's Manual of Determinative Bacteriology, first edition, published by David Berge in 1923, second edition 1925. Berge's Manual of Determinative Bacteriology, third edition, published in 1930. Subsequently, 8 editions are published. Berge's Manual of Determinative Bacteriology, 8th edition came. The 9th edition came as Berge's Manual of Systematic Bacteriology. It is known as first edition of Berge's Manual of Systematic Bacteriology. It was published in 1984 in 4 volumes. Volume 1, Volume 2, Volume 3 and Volume 4. Berge's Manual of Systematic Bacteriology, Berge's Manual of Systematic Bacteriology, first edition, it is published in 1984 in 4 volumes. 4 volumes. Berge's Manual of Systematic Bacteriology, first edition,
divides the kingdom prokaryote into four divisions on the basis of cell wall properties. Division 1, gracilely cutes, prokaryotes with thin cell walls which are typical of gram-negative organisms. Division 2 is called firmicutes, prokaryotes with thick cell walls indicating a gram-positive type of cell wall. Division 3, tenericutes, prokaryotes of a soft nature lacking cell walls are included in tenericutes. Division 4, mendocytes, prokaryotes having cell walls that lack peptidoglycan are included under mendocytes. So this Berger's manual of systematic bacteriology divided the kingdom prokaryote into four divisions. Division 1, gracilicutes, gram-negative organisms. Division 2, firmicutes, gram-positive bacteria. And division 3, tenericutes, prokaryotes lacking cell walls. And division 4, mendocytes, prokaryotes lacking peptidoglycan are included under mendocytes. So this is the classification of bacteria as per Berger's manual of systematic bacteriology, first edition. Berger's manual of systematic bacteriology, first edition, published in 1984 in four volumes. There the bacteria are divided into 33 sections. In this manual, bacteria were classified into 33 groups called sections. If you see these Berger's manual of systematic bacteriology, first edition, it has four volumes. Volume 1, where section 1, 2, section 11 are there. These are gram-negative bacteria that were considered as to have medical and industrial importance. Volume 2, section 12 to section 17, gram-positive bacteria are there in volume 2. Volume 3, section 18 to section 25, all remaining slightly different gram-negative bacteria along with archaea are classified from section 18 to section 25 in volume number 3. In volume number 4, consisting of section 26 to section 33, filamentous actinomycetes and other similar bacteria are included in volume number 4 from section 26 to section 33. Berger's Manual of Systematic Bacteriology, second edition. This represents a major departure from the first edition as well as from the 8th editions of Manual of Determinative Bacteriology. It follows phylogenetic framework based on analysis of nucleotide sequence of the 16S ribosomal subunit of RNA rather than a phenotypic structure. Earlier Berger's manuals, that is Berger's Manual of Determinative Bacteriology and Berger's Manual of Systematic Bacteriology, first edition, followed phenetic classification, whereas Berger's Manual of Systematic Bacteriology, second edition, follows the phylogenetic framework. This classification is based on analysis of ribonucleotide sequence of the ribosomal small subunit 16S ribosomal RNA. So based on this phylogenetic relationship, the classification was rearranged in the Berger's Manual of Systematic Bacteriology, second edition. Berger's Manual of Systematic Bacteriology, second edition, was published in five volumes. Volume 1 published in 2001, volume 2 in 2005, volume 3 in 2009, volume 4 in 2011, and volume 5 in 2012. So it is published in 5 volumes. Volume number 1 includes archaea and deeply branching and phototrophic bacteria. Volume number 1, Berger's Manual of Systematic Bacteriology, second edition, volume 1 contains archaea and deeply branching and phototrophic bacteria. So these are classified under volume 1. Volume 2 contains a single phylum, the Proteobacteria, which contains most of the gram-negative bacteria, and it represents the largest phylogenetically coherent group within the bacteria. Volume 2 is divided into 3 parts, 2A, 2B, 2C, and in volume 3, a single phylum, the Firmicutes, containing most of the gram-positive bacteria with a low G plus C content in the DNA. These are placed, Firmicutes containing most of the gram-positive bacteria with low G plus C content are placed in volume number 3. In volume number 4, a single phylum, Actinobacteria, containing most of the high G plus C gram positive bacteria are placed. High G plus C gram positive bacteria, the Actinobacteria, a single phylum Actinobacteria containing high G plus C content in the DNA are placed in volume number 4. Nine phyla, Planktomycetes, Chlamydiae, Spirochetes, Fibrobacters, Acidobacteria, Bacteroidetes, Fusobacteria, Verrucomicrobia, Dictyoglomi, these are placed, all are gram negative, and these are phylogenetically distinct from the Proteobacteria. They have been they are treated separately. Volume number 5, it contains all these organisms, Planktomycetes, Chlamydiae, Spirochetes, Fibrobacters, Acidobacteria, Bacteroidetes, Fusobacteria, and all these organisms are placed. In Berger's Manual of Systematic Bacteriology, second edition, volume 1 contains archaea and deeply branching and phototrophic bacteria. This volume was published in 2001. Volume 2 contains the Proteobacteria. This was published in 2005. It has 3 parts, and 2A, the introductory essays, and 2B, the gamma proteobacteria, and 2C contains other classes of proteobacteria. Volume number 3, published in 2009, it contains the Firmicutes, low G plus C gram positive bacteria, and volume number 4 contains the gram negative bacteria, Bacteroidetes, and Spirochetes, Tenericutes, Molecutes, Acidobacteria, Fibrobacteries, Fusobacteria, Dictyoglomi, and Lentispirae, and Verrucomicrobia, Chlamydiae, and Planktomycetes. These are there in volume number 4. This was published in 2011. Volume number 5, it contains 2 parts where Actinobacteria are placed. Volume number 5 contains Actinobacteria. It has 2 parts. It was published in 2012. Important features of Berger's Manual of Systematic Bacteriology, second edition, are: the prokaryotes have classified, prokaryotes have been placed in 2 domains, archaea and bacteria. Prokaryotes are classified into 2 domains, the archaea and the bacteria. So the domain archaea is again subdivided into phyla, Crinarchaeota and Eurarchaeota. Crinarchaeota and Eurarchaeota, domain archaea is again classified into 2 phyla, Crinarchaeota and Eurarchaeota.
The domain bacteria have been divided into 23 phyla. Domain bacteria have been divided into 23 phyla. These are the some important features of Berge's Manual of Systematic Bacteriology, second edition. In domain Archaea, two phyla are recognized, Crinarchaeota and Eurarchaeota. And in domain Bacteria, 23 phyla are recognized, Aquifice, Thermotoge, Thermodesulfobacteria, Deinococcus thermus, Chrysogenitis, Chloroflexi, Thermomicrobia, Nitrospirae, Deferrebacteris, Cyanobacteria, Chlorobi, Proteobacteria, Firmicutes, Actinobacteria, Planktomycetes, Chlamydiae, Spirochetes, Fibrobacteris, Acidobacteria, Bacteroidetes, Fusobacteria, Verrucomicrobia and Dictyoglomi. These are the 23 phylums under the domain Bacteria. Domain Archaea is divided into phylum Crinarchaeota and phylum Eurarchaeota. Phylum Crinarchaeota is again divided into class 1 Thermoproti. So there is one class Thermoproti in the phylum Crinarchaeota. In class Thermoproti, there are two orders. Order 1 Thermoproteales and order 2 Desulfurococcales. There are two orders, Thermoproteales and Desulfurococcales, under the phylum Crinarchaeota. Thermoproti, class Thermoproti contains order Thermoproteales. Order Thermoproteales contain family Thermoproteaceae, only one family Thermoproteaceae. Thermoproteaceae is the one family. The second family is Thermophyllaceae. Order Thermoproteales contain two families, Thermoproteaceae family 1 and family 2 Thermophyllaceae. Family 1 Thermoproteaceae contains genus Thermoproteus, Caldivirga, Pyrobaculum and Thermocladium. These are there in the Thermoproteaceae family. Thermoproteus is the important genera. Thermoproteus, straight or slightly curved rods, occasionally shows branching or with spherical bulbs, non-motile, growing at temperature 70 to 100 degree centigrade and a pH of 1.7 to 6.8, and these are obligate anaerobes, and these are chemolithoautotrophs. They reduce sulfur to elemental, they reduce sulfur and they produce H2S, and they use CO2 as sole source of energy. These are chemolithoautotrophs. They grow in hot springs, acidic hot springs. They grow in acidic hot springs in Ireland, Italy, North America, New Zealand, Indonesia, in other countries. The second family under Thermoproteales is Thermophyllaceae. The typical genus under this family is Thermophyllum. It is filament. Second order under Thermoproti is Desulfurococcales. Desulfurococcales contain the family Desulfurococcaceae. Desulfurococcaceae contain the genera Desulfurococcus, Acidolobus, Staphylothermus, Thermodiscus. Desulfurococcus, this is hyperthermophilic. Cells are cocci, grow at 85 to 90 degree centigrade. Maximum growth temperature is 97 degree centigrade. These are obligate anaerobes, and they show sulfur respiration with complex organic substrates. and the GC content is 42 to 51%.
Pyridoxaceae is the second family under order Disulfurococcalis. Typical representative genera are Pyridoxium, Hyperthermus and Pyrolobus. The third order under Thermoprotea is Sulfolobalis. Sulfolobales contain a single family, Sulfolobaceae. Typical representative genera of Sulfolobaceae are Sulfolobus, Acidianus, Metallospira, Sulfurispira, Sulfurococcus.
These are acidothermophilic organisms growing at temperatures, optimum temperature of 65 to 85 degrees centigrade and pH between 1 to 5.5. Sulfolobus cells are highly irregular in shape, often lobed but occasionally spherical. These are gram-negative, immotile or motile by presence of one or more flagella. These are obligate aerobes. Facultatively chemolitho-autotrophic in nature.
Phylum Eurarchaeota is much larger and more diverse than Crinarchaeota. It includes members having rods, cocci, irregular cocci, lancet-shaped, spiral-shaped, disc-shaped, triangular or square cells. They may be gram-positive or gram-negative, based on presence or absence of pseudomurine in cell walls. In some members, cell walls contain protein, or in some members, cell wall is absent. For example, thermoplasma. Phylum Eurarchaeota consists of 7 classes: Methanobacteria, Methanococci, Halobacteria, Thermoplasmata, Thermococci, Archaeoglobi, Methanopyri. These are the 7 classes under the phylum Eurarchaeota.
Phylum Eurarchaeota contains class 1 Methanobacteria. In class 1 Methanobacteria, there is one order, Methanobacterialis. Methanobacterialis contain 2 families. Family Methanobacteriaceae and Methanothermaceae. Methanobacteriaceae, it contains Methanobacterium, Methanobrevibacter, Methanospira, Methanothermobacter. So Methanobacterium is the typical genera representative of Methanobacteriaceae. Methanobacterium is a gram-positive rod-shaped bacteria. Its cell wall is composed of pseudomurine and its GC content is 32 to 61%. Optimum temperature for growth is 37 to 45 degrees centigrade. It produces methane and CO2. Methanobrevibacter is gram-positive methanogenic bacteria, gram-positive lancet-shaped bacteria. Its cell wall is composed of pseudomurine and it is gram-positive bacteria. Its optimum temperature is 37 to 40 degrees centigrade. Methanospira contain round cells, gram-positive cocci. Methanospira is its cell wall is composed of pseudomurine. Family 2 contains Methanothermaceae. Family 2 Methanothermaceae containing Methanothermaceae containing Methanothermus. Methanothermus is the typical representative of this family. Methanococci is class 2. Methanococci contains order Methanococcalis. Order 1 Methanococcales. So order 1 Methanococcales contains family 1 Methanococcaceae. The representative genera are Methanococcus and Methanothermococcus. Methanococcus and Methanothermococcus are gram-negative cocci. Their cell walls are composed of protein. These are motile, containing polar tuft of flagella. Family 2 contain Methanocladococcaceae. Family 2 is Methanocladococcaceae. The genera are Methanocladococcus and Methanotoris. Class 2 Methanococci contain second order Methanomicrobialis. Methanomicrobialis order contain family Methanomicrobiaceae. Methanomicrobiaceae contain genera Methanomicrobium, Methanoculeus, Methanopholis, Methanogenium and Methanoplanus. These are gram-negative bacteria. Their cell walls are composed of proteins. Order 3 of Methanococci is Methanosarcinalis. Methanosarcinalis order contain family Methanosarcinaceae. So Methanosarcinaceae contains genus Methanosarcina. Methanococcoides, Methanohalobium, Methanohalopilus, Methanolobus, Methanomicrococcus and Methanosalsum. Methanosarcinalis also contains family 2 Methanocetaceae, which containing the genus Methanoceta. Class 3 of Urarchaeota contains Halobacteria. Halobacteria, these are salt loving bacteria. These are extremely halophilic bacteria. This is the second largest group of the phylum Urarchaeota. Halobacteria contain single order Halobacterialis with a single family Halobacteriaceae. There are different genera. These are Halobacterium, Haloarcula, Haloferax, Halococcus, Halorubrum, Natrialba, Halobaculum, Halogeometricum, Haloterrigina, Natrinema, Natranomonas, Natranobacterium, Natranococcus and Natranorubrum. These are the 14 genera present in the halophilic archaea, Halobacteria, under the order Halobacterialis, under the family Halobacteriaceae. Halobacteria are rods, cocci and pleomorphic forms with some are flat and some are discs and some are with squares or triangles. And these organisms are either motile or non-motile, flagellated or non-flagellated, gram-negative or gram-positive, aerobic or facultatively anaerobic. Optimum temperature for growth is 35 to 50 degrees centigrade. These are chemoorganotrophs. These are chemoorganoheterotrophs. And these organisms, they grow at salt concentrations as low as 1.5 molar and up to as high as 5.2 molar. They optimum, most of the strains, they grow best at 3.5 to 4.5 molar salt concentration. But some, they can grow well even in saturated sodium chloride, in presence of saturated sodium chloride, they grow even at 5.2 molar salt concentration. Halophilic archaeobacteria not only salt tolerant, they grow even at near saturated salt concentrations. Because of this characteristic feature, they occur in salt lakes of Dead Sea and even Great Salt Lake. The majority of halobacteria have retinol-based pigments capable of producing light-dependent movement of ions across the cell membrane. The best known pigment is bacteriorhodopsin, an outwardly directed proton pump involved in energy conservation, the only non-chlorophyll mediated light energy transducing system in prokaryotes, that is present in the halophilic archaea. Class 4 of Urarchaeota is Thermoplasmata. Under thermoplasmata, there is one order, thermoplasmatales. Thermoplasmatales is the order. Thermoplasmatales contain families. Family 1, Thermoplasmatesi, and family 2, Picropylaceae, and family 3, Ferroplasmatesi. So, family 1, Thermoplasmatesi, contains thermoplasma. This is a pleomorphic organism varying in shape from spherical to filamentous structures, exhibiting budding characteristics. Cells lock a true cell wall and surrounded by a single triple layered membrane. Membrane lipids lock fatty acid ester residues. The lipids are ether linked. Ether lipids are characteristic of archaea. Thermoplasma is thermoacidophilic organism. Optimum growth 55 to 59 degree centigrade and optimum pH is 1 to 2. Picrophyllaceae, family 2 is Picrophyllaceae. Under Thermoplasmatales, family 2 is Picropylaceae. Genus Picropylus is classified. Family 3, Ferroplasmatesi. Genus Ferroplasma is classified. Phylum Eurarchaeota contain class 5 Thermococci. Thermococci class 5 contains order 1 Thermococcalis. Thermococcalis contain family Thermococcaceae, under which genus Thermococcus, Paleococcus, Pyrococcus are present. These are thermophilic organisms. Optimum temperatures between 75 to 88 degree centigrade, and they grow even at 103 degree centigrade also. Optimum pH 6 to 8, minimum pH 3 and maximum pH 9 for their growth. NaCl is required for their growth. Class 6 of Eurarchaeota is Archaeoglobi. Class 6 Archaeoglobi contain order 1 Archaeoglobalis. It contains a single family Archaeoglobaceae. It contains genus Archaeoglobus and Ferroglobus. Archaeoglobus is coccoid organism with 0.4 to 1.2 microns in the width. They occur singly and in pairs. These are gram negative with monopolar polytrichous flagella. They show blue-green fluorescence at 420 nanometers. They grow between 60 to 95 degree centigrade and in between the pH 5.5 to 7.5. These are strictly anaerobic. Sulfate or sulfite or thiosulfate are used as electron acceptors. Animals are composed of polypeptide. Phylum Eurarchaeota contain class 7 Methanopyri. Methanopyri contain order Methanopyrales, with the family Methanopyraceae, under which Methanopyrus is the genera. The phylum Eurarchaeota so contains 7 classes: Methanobacteria, Methanococci, Halobacteria, Thermoplasmata, Thermococci, Archaeoglobi, and Methanopyri. Eurarchaeota, phylum Eurarchaeota, physiologically divided into 5 major physiological groups: the methanogenic archaea, extremely halophilic archaea, archaea locking a cell wall, sulfate reducing archaea, and extremely thermophilic sulfur metabolizers.
Thank you for listening the lecture on first part of the Perge's Manual of Systematic Bacteriology, second edition.